years will be sorted out because of a huge development taking place in Pakistan, which is the BRT, the Chinese Belt and Road Initiative, which is connecting those parts of the world which were not connected before. So that's just one thing that will, in future, if we start working from now onwards, the trade between the two countries will increase. The second thing is that Pakistan is a virgin territory. Pakistan is still virgin in the sense that a lot of areas of trade where Pakistan has huge potential have not really started performing. For instance, Pakistan has huge mineral reserves, but we have hardly done exploration even in 5% of the areas where we are, where there's oil, there's gas, there's copper, there's cobalt, there's coal, and these areas have hardly been, any exploration has been done. But much more importantly, Pakistan has a population of 210 million people. It's one of the youngest population in the world. It has 120 million Pakistanis below the age of 35, which means it has tremendous amount of potential. And secondly is Pakistan's strategic position. It is connected to two of the world's biggest markets, China and India. And hence, Pakistan is on the verge. We are fixing our governance system. What we are trying to do is make it easier for businesses to work, the ease of doing business and cost of doing business. As we speak, we are trying to bring them down. So for businesses from Turkey, we will make it much easier. Already you've mentioned that various investors here I've met are already working in Pakistan. But I want to assure you that this government, its main aim is going to be to efforts and create wealth in the country. When you have trade, when you have investment, wealth is created. We desperately need, we have a young population which needs employment. So investment will lead to employment for us and create wealth. Pakistan is embarking on the next 5 years of building 5 million houses, affordable houses. It's a huge project. So your construction companies are welcome. We have, as I said, my team is here to answer questions. That's a huge initiative taken by Pakistan. Then we have, along with China, we are developing special economic zones along the BRT, the Belt and Road Initiative. And so again, it is a great opportunity for businesses from here to come and invest. But above all, we have what probably is one of the most diverse country in the world in terms of tourism. We have, I don't know whether most of you realize, out of the 12 or 13 highest peaks in the world, half of them are in Pakistan. Pakistan not only has a totally untapped mountain scenery, trekking, an area open for new resorts, but also Pakistan has also the most diverse religious tourism. It's the center of Buddhist civilization. It is the center for Sikh religious tourism, for Hindus. And it also has the oldest, well, I can't say this here because Turkey already, we know this area is probably the oldest civilization in the world. But in Pakistan, we have the Indus Valley civilization, which is 5,000 years old. And of course, it's a very historical part of the world. And for Turkey, people from Turkey, you must remember that the Turks were part of the ruling elite of the Indian subcontinent for almost six centuries. The Mughal Empire were Turkish origin. Before that, the Sultanate in Delhi for 300 years, it was basically, it alternated between the Turks and the Afghans. So it has this huge history. And let me not forget that when Turkey was finding its fighting for its independence, when the Greeks had invaded the mainland, people, what is now in Pakistan, then it was India, but from what is Pakistan, people were collecting money to support the Turkish movement for independence under Kemal Atatürk. So I look forward to your questions. I have my team here. You can ask questions. They can answer more specifically questions about various areas, about trade, about the measures which we've taken to open up our economy. So I look forward to your questions. Thank you.
Thank you very much. It's a great honor for us to, it's a very fruitful.
وزیر اعظم عمران خان انکرہ میں ترکی کے تاجروں اور صنعتکاروں سے خطاب کر رہے تھے ان کا یہ کہنا تھا کہ پاک ترک دو طرفہ تجارتی تعلقات کا فروغ ضروری ہے مزید انہوں نے یہ کہا کہ دونوں ممالک کے درمیان تجارتی حجم بڑھانے کی ضرورت ہے پاکستان میں سرمایہ کاری کے وسیع مواقع موجود ہیں اور انہوں نے ترک سرمایہ کاروں کو دعوت دی ہے کہ وہ پاکستان میں آئیں سرمایہ کاری کریں اور ان کا یہ کہنا تھا کہ پاکستان ترکی دو طرفہ تجارت کا فروغ بہت ضروری ہے اس خطے کی معاشی ترقی کے لیے پاکستان میں سرمایہ کاری کے وسیع مواقع موجود ہیں اور سرمایہ کاروں کو وزیر اعظم عمران خان نے دعوت دی ہے ترک سرمایہ کاروں کو کہ وہ پاکستان میں آ کے سرمایہ کاری کریں ان کا یہ کہنا تھا کہ پاکستان میں سرمایہ کاری کے وسیع مواقع موجود ہیں پاک ترکی دو طرفہ تجارتی تعلقات کا فروغ ضروری ہے اور انہوں نے یہ کہا کہ دونوں ممالک کے درمیان تجارتی حجم بڑھانے کی سخت ضرورت ہے انکرہ میں وزیراعظم عمران خان جو کہ ترکی دو روزہ ترکی کے دورے پر موجود ہیں اور وہاں پر تاجروں اور صنعتکاروں سے خطاب کر رہے تھے ان کا یہ کہنا تھا کہ پاکستان میں سرمایہ کاری کے وسیع مواقع موجود ہیں اور ترک سرمایہ کاروں کو انہوں نے دعوت دی ہے کہ وہ آئیں اور اپنی سرمایہ کاری کریں پاکستان کے اندر دونوں ملکوں کے درمیان تجارت کا حجم بڑھانے کی اشد ضرورت ہے ایسا کہنا تھا وزیراعظم عمران خان کا جبکہ آپ کو یہ بھی بتاتے چلیں کہ وزیراعظم دو روزہ ترکی کے دورے پر ہیں